This channel is supported by TrueFire. TrueFire is an online library of lessons from some of my favorite players. There's thousands of lessons on there. You can use the promo code JNC40 to get 40% off of any of their courses. Simultaneously one of the best tunes to learn for jazz and also one of the worst tunes to learn for jazz. This is for a couple of reasons. So one of the best things about it is that it is pretty much quintessential perfect bebop jazz lines that are kind of just kind of perfect. Perfect Charlie Parker kind of enclosures, perfect uses of, you know, 251s. There's some altered stuff in there. There's some diminished stuff in there. All of the really good stuff. The part that makes it a bad thing is that, like me, you could possibly learn it as one of your first jazz tunes and commit it to muscle memory and never really think about it particularly. So what I'd encourage you to do is maybe follow along with this video and learn it bit by bit and maybe even digest the smaller parts and try and transpose the smaller parts so that you can essentially explode it apart into lots of different little bits that are actually useful, because every one of these lines I think has value in and of itself and could sound really good in other contexts, so it's worth doing that with. I'm using it now as a warm-up each day because it's kind of cold in the UK, so going back and trying to relearn bits of it and, you know, from the muscle memory, try and maybe make that back to something where it's actual knowledge or something like that. The tab for this will be on Patreon with a backing track. Maybe I'll put a few backing tracks with like different tempos. I was trying to play it too fast for me in the intro there, but it's just kind of a little bit of fun. And yeah, let's dig into this. Probably a fairly crucial part of learning this tune is to at first get this idea under your fingers that you're not going to be picking every single note. It's going to be very challenging if you do. Personally, I play it sort of a little bit economy picked, but especially this part here is going to be hammer on, pull off. Right, so our very first kind of couple of bars. Okay, we get this kind of thing. So there are a few ways you could play it. I'm just going to show you the way that I play it. Tab will go up on screen as well. And maybe just break apart each part that I'm going to play sort of slowly. So that's our first phrase. Maybe we take each kind of phrase as like a breath that would have been played on the horns, and then we kind of So our first chord is A flat major. And we get this kind of major seven, then bebop. Then we fall to the third of an F7. And then a big jump. So like an F7 arpeggio there. And then off of the flat nine of the F, and with that same kind of hammer-on pull-off, you maybe attack on the upper note as well. Then we fall to the third of the B flat seven again. You could also play that here. I quite like to keep it roughly in the same position. Okay, so what we actually have there is a lick that would work if we're going from A flat to F to B flat. So you could, whilst you're practicing trying to get these little chunks, move it into other keys. That would be a B flat to G to C. Okay, right, then our second line, we're gonna go from this B flat becomes a B minor. So we're gonna do this one, which is really nice actually. We're gonna first of all enclose an E flat with the E and the D. Okay, and then like this. And then we approach the B flat from underneath as well, like that. So 7, 5, 6, 5, 6. And then all the way up, a B flat minor 7. So that's a really nice little. Yeah, and that's how I would play it. 5, 7, 5, 6, 5, 6, 4, 8, 6, 5, 4. And then an F minor arpeggio, so 5, 8, 6, 5. Descend to the 4. Augmented 4, 5, 6, 4, and then an A flat major from the first inversion 3, 6, 5, 3, 4. So you get so. And then we get a really, really, really sweet line. So we're gonna approach kind of like an E flat to A flat 2-5. And that's how I might play it. 6, 8, 4, 8, 6, 6, 5, 5. Then this next part is probably the trickiest part, but just again, just a recap. I might split that into two chunks. One, two. And then we get from the fourth fret, so this is happening over D flat, and then down to a D flat minor. Quite simple. And then we're getting into some kind of altered language. 7 5 4 6 5 5 6 3 4 5 5 6 3 4 6 5 3. Then we get into kind of minish kind of territory as well. So then from 5 7 5 4 6, and I would jump up 5 6 8 7 5, and this really weird, that kind of double enclosure. Once you get to this C, you slide down a fret to the 4th fret, down to the 7th fret, back up. And that one is one that has kind of gone from my muscle memory, so I need to... And then we fall down to this 5, 3, 5, 4, 3, onto the 7th fret. And then we get kind of the honeysuckle rose. So then 4 6 3 6 5 3 3 6, and then a nice E flat kind of arpeggio from the 3rd. So 5th fret, 3rd fret, 6th fret, 5th, and then that altered thing up at the top. And I would really encourage you to check this one out in loads of keys. That's like straight just jazz, isn't it? Okay, and then we repeat that start. And then we come down to this kind of C7, 5, 3, 2, 3, 5, 2, 3, 2, 5, 3, and then back up. Up to here, 6, 8, 6, 5, 8, and same again. And then approach the F from the 7th fret. Okay, then we get a bit of a chromatic thing. Okay, so that's essentially 5, 5, 4, 5, 6, 7, 6, 7, 4, 5, 5, 4, 5, 4, and then just chromatically down from the 7th fret. So 7, 6, 5, 4, you get. That's probably the easiest part of the tune. And then we get a really, really funky bit. Okay, and this is, again, straight jazz stuff. So 6th fret, 8, 6, 5, 6, 8, 6, 5, 6, 8, sorry. And then from here, we're going to be playing a G7 flat 9 arpeggio, or B diminished. So 7, 5, 8, 6, 9, and then from here, you kind of do this big jump. This will be worth shedding in and of itself. Okay. jump up to here, the third fret. 6, 5, 4, 6, 5, 3, and then harmonic minor. So here at the seventh fret, 6, 4, 3, 6, 4, 3. So then a D flat major arpeggio. Kind of E flat then. With that passing note there on the sixth fret. So once you put all these bits together, just practice each and every part of it until you're blue in the face, and gradually start to put them together. And you can kind of play it slowly, kind of play it with feel. And you know, just fill in the gaps. Join it up. And once you can play it slowly and start to join it up a bit, you'll notice the bits which are tripping you up constantly. And again, as I say, once you've got the whole thing learned and in muscle memory, don't just leave it there. Maybe think about just taking little chunks like that. And try and move that into other keys. And try and get the jazz into your soul that way. That's how I would approach learning Donnelly. Take it as slow as you need. And yeah, don't get too caught up in it just being a muscle memory exercise. It should be more than that for you, I think, because there's so much, and for me as well. And if you're finding bits that are hard to do, just slow it down and really hone in. Hopefully that helps. Feel free to like and subscribe. That's how I would play Donnelly and what I'm using to warm up a bit at the moment.